Today we're going to talk about the rooted product of graphs. To review, a rooted graph is a graph with a vertex designated as the root vertex. The rooted product of graphs takes as its first input a graph, which can be rooted or not, and as its second input, it takes a rooted graph. Intuitively, if we have our first input g and our second input h, then the rooted product of g with h is found by making one copy of h to correspond to each vertex in g, and then identifying, that is, merging, the root vertex in each copy of h with that copy's corresponding vertex in g. More formally, the vertex set of the rooted product of g with h is the Cartesian product of the vertex sets of g and h. The adjacency conditions for the rooted product are defined as follows. First, two vertices are adjacent in the rooted product if their left entries are the same vertex and their right entries are adjacent vertices. Our second condition says the two vertices are adjacent in the rooted product if their left entries are adjacent vertices and their right entries are the same vertex and equal to the root vertex in the second input graph. This might remind you of the Cartesian product, and for good reason. The rooted product of two graphs is a spanning subgraph of the Cartesian product of those two graphs. And the adjacency conditions for the rooted product are only slightly modified from those of the Cartesian product. Both products have this first adjacency condition, which essentially copies the second graph for each vertex in the first graph. The difference between these two products is in the second condition. Instead of considering all the possible adjacencies where the right entries are equal and the left entries are adjacent, we only consider those where the right entries are the root vertex and the left entries are adjacent. Another way to think about it is that the structure of the first input graph only appears once in the subgraph induced by the root vertices of each copy of the second input graph. Now let's take a look at some examples. What is the rooted product of these graphs, g and h, with g being the first input graph, h being the second, and with the root of h being vertex 1? First, find the vertex set, which is the Cartesian product of the input graph's vertex sets. Note that all the vertices which have a right entry equal to the root vertex in the second input graph are colored red. Next, let's find all adjacencies that derive from the first adjacency condition. We need to find all pairs of vertices with the same left entry and with adjacent right entries. For example, vertices A1 and A2 have the same left entry, A, and their right entries, 1 and 2, are adjacent in graph H. So A1 and A2 will be adjacent in the product graph. As an exercise, feel free to pause the video and find all of these adjacencies yourself. Here are the rest of the adjacencies that follow from the first adjacency condition. Note how this adjacency condition has essentially copied the second input graph once for each vertex in the first input graph. Next, let's find all the adjacencies that derive from the second adjacency condition. We need to find all pairs of vertices whose right entry is the root vertex 1 in H and whose left entries are adjacent. As an example, vertices A1 and B1 have right entries that are the same and equal to root vertex 1 in graph H, and their left entries, A and B, are adjacent in graph G. Therefore, A1 and B1 are adjacent in the product graph. Again, feel free to pause the video and find the rest of these adjacencies yourself. Here they are. Note how we have copied the first input graph exactly once, using the vertices whose right entry equals the root vertex in the second input graph. Moving on to our next example, let's find the rooted product of g with h prime, where h prime is the same as h from our previous example, except that the root of h prime is vertex 2. Again, find the vertex set. Then, find all the adjacencies that derive from our first condition. Feel free to pause the video and find these yourself. Here they are. Notice how they're the same edges that we found from the first adjacency condition in the previous example. Changing the root vertex of the second input graph did not change which edges came from the first adjacency condition. Next, let's find all the adjacencies that derive from our second condition. These will be between vertices whose right entry equals the root vertex, 2, and whose left entries are adjacent. Here they are. This is the result of the rooted product of g with h prime. Notice that it is not isomorphic to our previous result. An easy way to see this is that our current result has vertices of degree 5, while our previous result does not. This demonstrates that it matters what vertex in the second graph is the root vertex. To demonstrate another useful property of rooted products, let's take the rooted product of these two trees, T and S, with S's root vertex being vertex 3. First, find the vertex set. Next, find all the adjacencies that come from our first condition. Then, find all the adjacencies that come from our second condition. The resulting graph is still a tree. That is, it's an acyclic connected graph. This is because the rooted product does not produce cycles when its input graphs are acyclic. And it's straightforward to show that the rooted product of two connected graphs is connected. Basically, the reason why the rooted product of acyclic graphs is acyclic is that cycles in a rooted product are either entirely contained in one of the copies of the second input graph, or entirely contained within the single copy of the first input graph. The green cycle highlighted is one that is entirely within the first copy of the second input graph, and the red cycle highlighted is one that is entirely within the single copy of the first input graph. If neither input graph had cycles, our product graph would have no cycles. This is unlike the Cartesian product, as the Cartesian product of two acyclic graphs could have cycles. Let's move on to another example which will demonstrate another property of rooted products. Let's find the rooted product of these two cycle graphs, X and Y, where graph Y has root vertex 1. First, find the vertex set. Next, find the adjacencies that come from the first adjacency condition. These will produce our copies of graph Y. Next, find the adjacencies that come from the second adjacency condition. These will produce our single copy of graph X. This is our result. Notice that this graph does not contain a Hamiltonian cycle, even though its input graphs did contain Hamiltonian cycles. This demonstrates an interesting difference between Cartesian products and rooted products. Unlike the Cartesian product, the rooted product of two Hamiltonian graphs is not necessarily Hamiltonian. In fact, it will never be. The intuition is that we would get stuck if we tried to visit all the vertices in the graph, as we would be forced to visit some vertices more than once. To demonstrate, suppose we take the rooted product of two Hamiltonian graphs, G and H, and let V sub k be some vertex in the kth copy of graph H, and V sub p be some vertex in the pth copy of graph H. As an example in this graph, suppose we chose vertices A2 and C3 as our V sub k and V sub p, respectively. Let's attempt to construct a Hamiltonian cycle starting at V sub k. As if a Hamiltonian cycle exists, the choice of starting vertex doesn't matter. If V sub k is not the root of copy k, then in order to eventually reach V sub p, we would have to cross the root vertex of copy k. But if we do so, we can never return back to V sub k without passing through the root vertex of copy k again. As our second case, if V sub k was the root of copy k, which in our graph might mean we chose vertices A1 and C3 as our V sub k and V sub p, then our first move must be to a vertex in copy k. Otherwise, we could never reach any of the vertices in copy k without visiting V sub k, our initial vertex, more than twice. But after we take that first move, we're going to be forced to complete a Hamiltonian cycle in copy k, coming back to vertex V sub k, but missing all the other vertices in the graph. Note that this also demonstrates that any rooted product, where the input graphs both have more than one vertex, is not Hamiltonian, which is a much more general property that covers the case when both input graphs are Hamiltonian. To finish the video, let's do a quick summary. The rooted product is a way of combining a graph with a rooted graph. The vertex set of the rooted product is the Cartesian product of the input graph's vertex sets, and it has the following two adjacency conditions. Essentially, the rooted product copies the second input graph once for each vertex in the first input graph, and then links just the root vertices of those copies according to the structure of the first input graph. The choice of root vertex for the second input graph affects the resulting product. The rooted product of two trees is a tree. And more generally, the rooted product of two acyclic graphs is acyclic, and the rooted product of two connected graphs is connected. Finally, the rooted product of two Hamiltonian graphs is not Hamiltonian. That's it for this video. In future videos, we'll take a look at Hamiltonian cycles and Eulerian circuits in simplex graphs. We'll also take a deeper look at some graph products. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe if you enjoyed the video. Have a great day.